Assalamu alaikum. Next is the factors inducing dispersal. What factors are responsible for dispersal? Definitely, first one is the population pressure. If the number of organisms is more, then it causes the migration of animal. Then it causes the migration or dispersal of animals. Lack of the food supply, a lack of the space, adverse environmental conditions, sudden calamities such as fire, wood, flood and typhoon. ये जैसे आपने देखा था पिछले दिनों ऑस्ट्रेलिया के जंगलात में आग लग गई थी, तो बहुत सारे एनिमल्स ने वहाँ से एस्केप की कोशिश की थी. जो एस्केप कर गए थे, डिस्पर्स हुए, वो तो सेव हो गए, लेकिन जो एस्केप नहीं कर सके वो जल गए थे. चेंज ऑफ हैबिटेट, ओपनिंग ऑफ न्यू एरियाज एल्सवेयर. नेक्स्ट इज़ द बैरियर ऑफ डिस्पर्सल. दिस इज़ मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट फ्रॉम पेपर पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू describe the definition of the barriers. What are barriers? They are the hindrance in the dispersal or distribution of animals. Barriers are the hindrances in the distribution of animals or in the distribution or dispersal of animals. Barriers are always relative. अब आप ये नहीं कहेंगे कि barriers हमेशा एक पहाड़ barrier ही होगा. Animals के हिसाब से या एक दूसरे के हिसाब से barriers relative होते हैं. Because barrier for one group is not always a barrier for another group. For example, water is a barrier for the land animals or the mammals. Okay, water is a barrier for a sheep, but it is not a barrier for a crow. Because crow have feathers, crows have feathers and have ability to take a flight and cross the large river. But sheep cannot cross that large river, so water is a barrier for the sheep. Similarly, land animals may have their movement restricted by the high mountains, but flying animals cannot cross the barriers. Again, the barriers have not remained constant in the geological past. Land masses and the sea boundaries have shifted, providing either means of dispersal or creating barriers. This group of animals became isolated or died out or evolved into new species. For example, there are no camels in North America today, but their fossils are found in abundance, indicated once these animals were widely distributed throughout the North America. अब ये कह रहे हैं कि land masses और जो sea boundaries हैं वो भी shift होती रहती हैं, वो भी dispersal में important role play करती हैं. अगर आप आज North America को देखें तो वहाँ पर आपको camels नहीं मिलेंगे, लेकिन जब paleontologists वहाँ study को जाते हैं तो उनको वहाँ से camels के fossils मिले. इसका मतलब ये है कि geological past में वहाँ पर कैमल्स थे, और ये इस बात की इंडिकेशन है कि लैंड मासेस कांस्टेंट नहीं रहते. अब बैरियर्स को क्लासिफाई किया जाता है फिजिकल बैरियर्स, माउंटेन्स, ओशंस एंड द डेजर्ट्स, क्लाइमेटिक बैरियर्स सच एज़ टेम्परेचर, ह्यूमिडिटी, लाइट एक्सेट्रा, बायोलॉजिकल बैरियर्स सच एज़ वेजिटेशन, प्रीडेटर्स एंड द कंपीटिटर्स एक्सेट्रा. Physical barriers, mountains, high extensive mountain ranges are the effective topographical barriers which prevent the animals from crossing. Topography is the arrangement of natural and artificial features of an area. For example, Himalayan range is effective barrier between India and Eurasia. Eurasia is the word collectively used for the whole Europe and the Asia. EUR for Europe and Asia comes from Asia. So the word used is the Eurasia. Actually, Nepal and Bhutan are present. They are adjacent with the India, and Himalayan range is present to separate the India from the China on the southern side. The moist hot plains of India have elephants, rhinoceros, tigers, deers, and the peacocks, etc. Moist plains are the flat areas. They are either sometime covered by the hills or sometime covered by the cliffs. Cliff, C-L-I-F-F. Cliff are the vertical or vertical exposure of rocks. ये ज़्यादातर ना आपको समंदरों के किनारे पे मिलेंगी. ये जो rocks बिल्कुल 90 के angle पे या approximate vertical होती हैं, expose हो जाती हैं due to erosion, उन्हें आप कहते हो cliffs. Moist plains सीधे areas होते हैं, ये higher elevation पे नहीं जाते, आप इन्हें mountains के अंदर plains जो है mountains को के अंदर इनको आप consider नहीं कर सकते. Whereas it's on its northern side, climate being temperate, ये आपको detail में सारे पढ़ाऊंगी, tropical temperate और ये सारे. Fauna include animals like oxen, sheep, pigs, hyenas, etc. Water bodies such as the vast ocean or the sea channels form notable barriers to the distribution of such animals as amphibian, reptiles, and the mammals. The fact that sea act as effective barrier can be well illustrated by the example of the Mozambique Channel. Actually, this is the extension of the Indian Ocean, and we separate the two countries, Madagascar and the Mozambique. Mozambique is the country of the East Africa. This channel is 40 kilometer wide, yet the fauna of two regions are quite different and distinctive. To the modern amphibia, seawater is most effective barrier because seawater has salt, and the amphibians mostly cannot regulate the amount of water and salt in the body, in their body. So if these amphibia enter into the seawater, it causes osmoregulatory problems. Freshwater fishes if enter into the seawater, they also face same osmoregulatory problems. Water bodies, however, are not barriers to those animals which have sustained power of flight, like birds and the bats. Deserts, extensive dry desert also become effective barrier because in deserts no food supply is available for a long time, as well as the water supply is also in scarcity. So water scarcity along with the high temperature, this is not possible for animals to survive in such extreme conditions. Sahara Desert affords a very good example. It is a demarcation between the Ethiopian and Palearctic regions. In the south, animals such as gorilla, zebra, giraffe, rhinoceros, elephants are found, whereas these animals are absent from the northern side. On the contrary, in north are present mammals such as goats, pigs, oxen, etc. Similarly, the Kalahari Desert, the area of the Kalahari Desert is 9 lakh kilometer, and it is responsible for the distinctive fauna of Central Africa from that of Cape of Good Hope. This is the province of the South America at its southern tip.